Welcome to the set Dark vs. Repard. We are going over this set now from recorded games and a little bit sped up. So only in one video, not in three. And I already said to the chat on stream that this is the first time that at least I see... This isn't working well with the lighting here. It's the first time that I see the Civ, the map Socotra in this tournament. We also have Zvol for Repard and Graveyards is the neutral map. As the Civ's Dark can go for Romans, Burmese, Portuguese, Koreans or Goth. And Repard has Mayans, Incas, Turks, Teutons and Aztecs open for himself. All three Meso-Civs. And if we think about graveyards, I would see Aztecs for Repard here. Incas, Mayans also work, but I would prefer Aztecs. Depending on the Civ matchup that we expect, Dark most likely will go for Romans. Portuguese also an option. And against those Civs, I don't see much that goes against Aztecs. I would predict them. Then if we're looking at Zvol, Turks and Teutons are insane for Repard. Dark, I would personally pick Portuguese, but Burmese is also great. And on Socotra, Dark has Goth. Could Koreans work there? Don't really see them on Zvol and Graveyards. Maybe with towers making the life hard for Repard there with them. Also defense upgrade on not really. That doesn't help too much on Socotra. We will see. And for Repard, Incas could be nice on Socotra. But we start into the set with Graveyards. And there we will have Romans versus Mayans being played. And there we go. Mayans with a 4 will start here for Repard. Builds 3 houses immediately. Interesting. Makes sense though. I think there's enough space for a farm, right? Yeah, yeah. To be. And Dark is going for the Romans. Let's fast forward a bit here. Normally there's not much happening. Repard is scouting with sheep and with his eagle. He's going forward now. Dark is sending his scout forward as well. Oh, 1 sheep stolen, 2 sheep stolen, boar stolen. Repard is going crazy here. Good thing for the eagle normally. You can fight against the scout. Bad fight. You can't fight against the scout after laming a boar, but you're also slower, so you can't run away either. The scout runs into the TC. 1 sheep is still hidden here. I think the other one was recollected for Dark. But once again, the Eagle Scout survives and the Scout Cavalry dies after a laming attempt. We have seen that already in the last match where MBL could get the boar in though as well. No, definitely a reason why he is called Master Boar Lamer sometimes. But in this game, Dark is going up with Pop 17. This is originally pop 18. Okay, he's going up pop 19 minus the scout, therefore pop 18 right now. Repard is going up later. Is Repard adding a barracks yet? Yes, there we go. Dark is adding that as well. And Dark is 2 vills up earlier to the feudal age. Therefore Repard with 3 vills more. He had 1 more at the beginning of the game already. And Repard now gets the pick home. Can scout the militia now coming forward. We won't see the man-at-arms upgrade. The only now on gold is dark. Maybe a third militia? Yes, there we go. And two vills forward. Will we see towers? There's a house. I wonder what that will be. House isn't even finished. But Dark needs one soon. And there will be the tower. I would have preferred that here. So it reaches the gold. Oh, and Dark is in with the militia. It won't find any kills. Especially not with Loom, but it is annoying. Just takes away time from Repard. And this tower should be here, in my opinion. Now we reach the mining camp, but not the gold. So the Vils could still mine gold, take a shot every now and then when they are putting it away, but takes so long until the Vilts are getting significant damage in then. There's an archer now fighting against the militia, and we'll scout the tower now. Defensive tower is coming up, but that is way too late. Tower is up, and now the Vilts are getting at least harassed. Let's see if it goes up at all. Those Vils here are blocking the militia, fighting them as well. TC is doing some damage. Oh, militia is still annoying the Vils that wanted to build the tower. Killed one even. The tower will most likely go up and will have more Vils in it, so more firepower. But it has done some damage already. And Romans also repair faster. Vil can't repair safely. Tower is a bit too close for that. And what? Okay. Let me check the eco here. Repard with more resources collected, but it's only a difference of 2 right now. It's now 8. And he didn't add any farms yet, so he didn't invest any of those resources to get more resources, except for the usual mining camp, lumber camp stuff. But that is what Repard has as well. And Repard, without fletching yet, Dark is researching it right now. And Dark, with the better army defending here, one square more makes a big difference. And this tower is abandoned by Dark. Sent out his wills to the left side. They might just go for a mining camp here. And what feels fairly safe. Okay, Dark now has fletching in, loses his tower though. Basically the moment it could reach the wills here. That one went down. And the wills are returning home. Repard still with his one vill advantage. Dark with 10 seconds more of idle TC time, won't matter too much. And Repard lost one vill. Why does Repard have 2 vills more? If he lost one? One lost should balance out the bonus. Still has 2 more. Idle TC time isn't telling the story here. We don't have wheelbarrow. Both have researched loom. Ready. I am confusion. Oh, can the eagles get a will kill here? No. Moving back. And now some skirm fighting here, not too much happening. Dark is getting the defense upgrade for the skirms. And I'm thinking about the army composition in the Castle Age. Last set, I've already talked about how Mayans often struggle against siege plus militia line pushes. If the militia line has more pierce armor, like the Romans do. And I think Castle Age, Longswordman plus Mangonel and maybe Oram is really hard for Mayans to defend. Even if repard is at the moment dictating the game here, making it hard for Dark. Not finding that much damage. This could be dangerous now for the wilds. One goes down here. Second one maybe. Eagle takes care of the skirm. But the wild can escape. And the scouts are not enough against multiple archers plus two eagles. Now only one left, but still a win for repard, who is in the better spot right now, I think. And he is buying food. He is on the way to the Castle Age way earlier than Dark. Dark still needs basically all the food. Is queuing more skirms. And I think repard can fall back now. Maybe switch into eagles. Is building another barracks. So, plans to at least add more eagles. If I would play this, and that is definitely not the play, therefore, I would go for all in eagles. He sadly can't sell his stone unless he collects 25 more and then sells one batch. But send more wills from wood to gold and for this gold pile here, and then just send in the eagles. We now have two barracks. Eagle production will be great against the skirms, is more than solid against scouts. And finally, Dark can click up to the Castle Age as well. And this one eagle harassing the skirm so much. Doesn't have a kill yet. That should change soon. Now crossbow and bodkin is coming in. Both upgrades are there. The crossbows can fight against the skirms. Especially if the eagle and the spearmen here are decimating them a little bit more. Not the best health on them already. And Dark has to build a defensive tower. He has wilds on stone. Will the tower go up in time? I'm not sure. Oh, that hurts so much. Losing more and more wilds here, and the tower is at 85%. It's not like one wild with one hit could get it up. Repard wins this. Dark just lost too much and couldn't get to the Castle Age in time. Really solid game, at least, by Repard. Who's one ahead now and has won with his first pick against the first pick of his opponent. What am I doing here? Ah. Ignore the 8 in the corner. Alright, let's then see. Next game will be on Socotra, right? Unless Dark wants to play Zaval first, but nope. He won't. And we get a matchup that I assume we'll go for a lot of towers. As we have in red here, repard with Incas. Could go really well for man-at-arm towers. The extra llama helps out. The cheaper towers are helping out. And especially in the castle age onwards, if we're having the defense upgrade for... already a lame here, maybe? No. Dark won't find anything. Will Rapid find anything? No. Boar's in. And yeah, no Goth here. Is a bit surprising to me as well. Maybe Dark didn't want to play against Incas. Oh, Rapid here. Ran into the range of the TC. Of his opponent and then fought. Repard has a will forward to kill the ostriches. Three are dead here already on the side of Repard as well. Don't give those to your opponent. And Repard has his berries walled in. Maybe Dark didn't want to fight against Incas with Goth. That's the only explanation why we don't go for Goth here, I think. Even though the ostriches are getting lamed all the time, basically. So it's not the most effective bonus now with the longer lasting hunt if we only have one elephant. Not the second one that we have on most maps. But yeah, I really like Goth on this map. And Dark is up to the castle age soon. He already has loom. He doesn't have any buildings, though. And not enough food either. Has a will queued. Okay, I was a bit scared what that is. What kind of crazy... Oh, is Rapid now going forward and build a mill here maybe? He won't build a mill on his berries. He could build one on the berries of Dark. Oh, but Dark doesn't want that to happen in his backyard. Or front yard, it rather is. And with the hell bonus, he can scare away Rapid. Also wants to get some food from this ostrich. And will get some downhill hits again. Both players do have loom. And therefore, it's not that much that is happening here right now. And I think Rapid only now saw that his berries are walled in. Yeah, he didn't know about it before. Ouch, he wanted to build a mill there. And then had to rethink his plans. As a lumber camp now, but still no mill. While Dark has both buildings to click up. Builds a mill right in the middle of nowhere. Well. The ostriches here have run out. These are not really usable for him. He has to build the mill somewhere. I still would have preferred it here and then fight the palisade walls with the will. But that Rapid has to invest wood now into farms to get food hurts him a lot. Like, it's crazy how much that hurts his eco. And that forces Rapid to build walls as well, invest into that. But it won't stop Dark from coming in with some wills now, and he's going for towers, right? And it's a weak will that is walling here. Great spot by Dark that he only had to send over one will. And the tower here will not deny the walls, but will make it very easy to get through them and very hard to defend them. Dark starts to attack them. Ooh, this tower won't fight against this tower unless we have fletching. But it will fight against wills that try to get in here. Nice wall off against the Vild. Oh, and even with Fletching, we won't be able to attack this tower. But now Dark will go through here. Maybe a tower here would be helpful. Oh, he tries to get in at the same place he tried it before. And gets some damage in against his Vilds, but they will be healed up again. Dark, make sure that no Vild is going for the berries here. And now Dark can run through the wall. Won't lose a Vild, I think. Walls in his tower. I like that. What are we doing? Oh, Dark won't be able to get a tower up here. All those Vilds would stop him. And Repard has to see that. He always has to think, what are those Vilds doing now? Let's see which castle goes up first. Repard was too late in my opinion, but has so many more Vilds there. His tower should go up first. But there's already an archer for Dark, and that one has the defense upgrade. And castle goes up first for Dark, but not by that much. And Dark has Vilds under the tower of Repard. Walls them in. And can fight the tower now. Unless Repard gets a defensive tower up against that. I'm not sure if that will be fast enough. I wouldn't mind it if we delete the palisades here and get the Vild out to repair. Yeah, and Repard is able to defend that. Hello, Yo-Yo. Oh, did I say castle? I obviously meant tower. On this side, nothing happening. On this side, nothing happening. Everything interesting is happening here right now. Something died. I think Repard lost the Vild. He has two Vilds behind. Both players with roughly one Vild worth of idle TC times. And towers are so weak now. Yes and no. I think they are in a solid spot. And I really like it that they were nerfed so that they are not that good as an aggressive option. They were never meant as something aggressive, more defensive. And in reality, it's the same. Which medieval army decided to build towers forward somewhere on the battlefield. There just wasn't the time for it. Obviously, if you're building a side base, as we call it in AoE, or have a camp or something like that for your army, that could have worked, but it's obviously tricky. But defensively, they are still good, and in-game and in real life. Repard is in an okay spot. Not having his berries, as I said, hurt him a lot. He's building another tower. They are cheaper for him, but Dark collects stone faster. So Dark should get a very slight bit easier onto multiple towers. But Repard can build more with the stone he has available for himself. Oh, and this tower, will it go up first? No, Repard pulls enough Vilds. I think they died a Vild on this tower? No. Somewhere something died. And the Vilds can't be reached, I think. So the tower will go up. Archers are taking a lot of damage here. I don't like that Repard doesn't have Fletching. It's recharging it now. And yeah, Socotra without a douche. It's hard to witness that Now with fletching, these wills won't be able to repair from safety. Both quite far away from the Imperial, the Castle Age Dark, a bit closer, but Dark lost his two wills here. Now we have two villager kills, and Repard is one will ahead. I wonder why. Idle time, only 8 seconds difference. Both loom, both no wheelbarrow. Five archers versus 5 wilds. Obviously better for Dark to have all his wilds working. Also had 5 archers in here, but we'll lose the tower. Can't really repair it. Has no wilds around, and those wilds he could send there in danger. Dark buying himself up to the Castle Age now. Repard will feel like he can get some ground. And if he gets enough towers up... those... Without the wills in the watchtower, the archers can go for the wills that try to build the tower here. I wonder though if this tower will go up. Yeah, this one is far more safe here. And I think Repard doesn't see it. Okay, he sees it by one tile. Archers can't really come closer. But this tower will deny this one most likely. Let's compare the progress. Okay, Repard now with more wills at the tower, and therefore will get his one up first, but not by that much. And there are archers again in this tower. And in roughly 50 seconds, the watchtowers will be upgraded to guard towers immediately. And Repard runs out with his wills here, wants to kill the tower, I assume. Yeah, and he might lose a will there, but could be worth it for him. Pulls back this one will. Now we have guard tower, and they have 2 attack more and 1 range. No range upgrade for them. Okay, but the 2 attack make a big difference, especially if we have archers and wilds in the towers, and therefore shooting more arrows. Bit more armor as well. And a castle for Dark. And Repard resigns this. Okay. Yeah, Repard never really got into gold. That was his problem. He could have sold some... he could have gone up to the Castle Age. I think he was on the way to the Castle Age, right? But without gold, it's extremely tricky. And that means, even though Dark didn't go for the Goth here, he won with Koreans in the Tower War. You predicted the castle in Feudal Age correctly. Exactly. That was what I meant. In Dark's Feudal Age, we will see a castle from Repard. I just shortened that to a castle. Repard problem was Dark's uptime. Yes, I absolutely agree. The castle here now, especially with Botkin Arrow not too far in the future, and those towers here completely deny him from gold. This one is denied by this tower right now. And green screen from hell. Wouldn't have said it that heavily. But yeah, it's not going great. Still don't really have something to fix that. But I could cut out my body. I'm a floating head. Oh no, my hair is gone. I'm not feeling great, Mr. Stark. Let me try something. Not happy with that. Ah, I know why it looked weird. This is the screen I used to edit the scoreboard, and the scoreboard is on a green screen as well. Maybe I should change that to blue screen or red screen or something like that. Yeah, this screen is so green that it colors my face as well. Maybe it changed that, the color. All right, we finished game two and it's 1-1 and will now be fought off on the wall. The greatest map of all times. The wall, the wall. And I predict Portuguese versus Turks here. Even though Teutons, Aztecs, Burmese, all great civs here as well. And we can go into the game, and it looks like I was right. We have Stark with Portuguese here and Repard with Turks here. Let's fast forward quite a lot because the wall in the middle is preventing them from doing anything crazy to each other. They don't see the wall, so they don't see when the opponent is coming through. I think by now you have seen the map already. And Lonesome Rider is playing the correct music for this map. Repard is already going for the walls here. And yeah, I am ghost. This is a bit better now. Repard is on the way to the castle age pop 28. Dark is going for pop 31. Is that a fast imp? Or is that double castle? It feels really late. And I need to slow down the game now, as Repard is building a monastery and a castle in the middle, something we basically see every game. And I try to fix the green screen on the side while the predictable things are happening. Fast imp hand cannons? I would say fast imp block printing. Hand cannons don't feel great against Turks. I'm casting from the 9th dimension. You're underestimating my power. This is dimension number 120. And yeah, we see Monastery Castle as well from Dark, and Dark is close to imping. Oh, he could go for Fatoria eco. Just like 35 builds, but 3 Fatorias immediately. And yeah, that can be crazy strong for like 10 minutes. And green screen. I don't know what this is. Making it tough for me today. You will have to live with that. Okay, Repard is going for his unique unit, the Janissary. Then has some ramps here to get through the wall. I don't... Okay, it doesn't make sense to attack the piece of wall here that he already attacked with the scout. That is around half HP. Ooh, and Dark went for some stone walls here. And indeed, Dark is on the way to the Imperial Age. Has some fills on stone still, on gold here. Is correct, collecting the relics. And if he can keep the Janissaries out, he will be able to convert them from his side of the wall with block printing without them ever being able to come back. Atonement could convert the mocks. At the moment, 5 range versus 7 range. Sorry, 9 range against 7 range is already enough, but can be tricky over the wall. Oh, when now 3 ramps are coming in. I think the light calf here gets killed by the castle, yeah. Janissary is placing themselves right under the castle, but could be converted by the monks. Organ guns are coming out. One monk down. Scout down, Vils are fighting the organs, and Twitch, no commercials now. Monks can convert Janissaries every now and then. Rams are falling to the Vils, and losing Vils is not the worst thing right now for Dark. He will be able to get some eco running soon as he is an imp. Getting some more gold will be important though. Oh, and Dark jumps in and out of the castle to fight the ram, hide from the Janissaries, and repair the castle. Nice. One Vil was a little bit too close to the castle of Repard. One conversion comes in. Second conversion was on the dying Janissary. Whoa! And Repard resigns already. He has a 10-vil lead, castle is almost down, but still says, I don't want to fight against your Fetoria Echo in a moment, and my attack was stopped. GG. Therefore, Dark wins this after being behind in after game one. That was fast. They lost, and these guys here, the Portuguese, they have won. And we are also giving a point to Dark and are saying GG.